Chief Secretary, Mr. Sharad Sharma, Chief Executive Officer of Brand Sigma, Mr. Akhil Arora, Secretary Information Technology Communications, Government of Rajasthan, distinguished guests, participants, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, it's a great pleasure to have you all here with me today. And I really wish to welcome you very warmly to Rajasthan's IT Day celebrations. For us, this is a very, very important celebration because we are stepping across the threshold into a new world. This new world is a world which spans a very large state, because I'm not going to go into what's happening in the rest of the country. But the largest state in the country, Rajasthan, 7.5 crore people spread across this vast state. Urban areas and rural areas, all of them, aspirational youngsters wanting to step into the new world today. Aspirational youngsters who wish to be able to connect not just within their country, but even outside their country. Aspirational youngsters who believe that it's not important just to work in their small pond, but maybe across the length and breadth of their state. Not just the length and breadth of their state, but maybe across the length and breadth of their country. And maybe not just their country, but who wish to make their world, the whole world, their oyster. And I say today, why should that not happen? If you took us 10 years back, I think there would be many of us who would still have these queries. Can it be done? Can it not be done? I remember, if you all don't mind, can you just keep this quiet? What I would like very much to say is that when I first came to government and went to Goa, I remember there were a lot of people from the IT, they were just becoming famous. And names like Narayan Murthy, Premji, all of these were making a lot of difference. They were making waves in India. Today there are, I mean, so many more. And all of them are known. Whether they're making apps, whether they're making companies, or whether they've gone beyond that. But I remember very well people saying, Rajasthan and IT? And I could see going across their face, deserts, camels, people still who haven't stepped out of the shadows. And I could see them thinking, here you are in a place like Goa where things are happening, where kids are rocking, where so many things are interesting, and we are talking about Rajasthan and IT. And today, 10 years down the line, or let's say 15 years down the line, I can say very proudly that yes, we are. And we're not just talking IT, but we're saying to you, all of you, be here today with us, start up your own setup. Work with us, be a partner with us in Rajasthan to change the lives of our millions of people, to change your own life, and to step across the world in one giant stride. Can we do it?
Yes,
yes we can. And that's the Obama line, I want you to remember that. Yes, we can. It's just about hard work, it's about application, and it's about standing shoulder to shoulder, being proud of your state, and being able to do things that people throw to you as a challenge. People said to us that day, Rajasthan can't do it. And we proved to them that we can. And that is why you are here today, and that is why we have insisted that amongst all the things that we do, that IT will be celebrated. That those who are contributing will be celebrated. That their names will be remembered. It's not just about a gift. It's about who and how many they have been able to help. It is about all of you. Have you been able to actually step out? It's not about making money. Yeah, some of it is about making money. Because if I didn't make the money, I wouldn't want to make the app. If I didn't want to make the app, then I wouldn't be doing IT. But I'm doing all of that because I actually want to step out across the world. And why shouldn't I be another Steve Jobs? Why shouldn't I be another Gates? Why shouldn't I be any of these people that we talk about and we admire so greatly? And all of us can be. That's the beauty of it all. None of this is a secret anymore. It's all there before all of us. It's a question of application. And as I said, it's a question of pride. So today, we are tackling Bangalore head on. We're taking Karnataka head on. We're looking at Maharashtra head on. We're looking at any of the states. What I'm saying to say is, we are not interested. We are interested to see how well we do. We are now not competing with this one or that one. We're competing with ourselves, exactly. We are competing now with ourselves. We have to get better and better and better at what we do and let the others compete with us. Can we do it?
Yes.
Yes, we can. So, this is why I'm saying today, it's not been easy. It's not been easy, folks, because we have actually managed to step across that threshold, but it was very, very hard work. And you can see, just by what you saw just now, that things are going to change, but they're going to change very slowly. But there are people across our state who are desperate to learn this language. This language is a language which is going to join caste to caste, creed to creed. There is no big, there is no small. It's a question of application and it's a bind. If any of us have it, whatever caste you are, whatever creed you are, you can step right across that world and shake hands with who you want. Do you want to do it? Yes or not?
Yes.
Because I believe that the people who are sitting over here are those who are going to take this torch into the villages of Rajasthan to show the light to those people and make them understand that this is a language which is not difficult. It is a language which is easy. It's a language which connects you with people. It's a language which makes you care for people. And it's a language which makes you earn for yourself. It's a language which will allow you to stand on your own two feet. And because of you, it will allow your state to stand on its own two feet. Can you do it?
Yes.
I think the time has come. I think that time has come, and I'm sorry that I was a little harsh with all of you, but you have to understand, they're trying. Some of them have understood that this may make money. Some of them are still not understanding why it's so important. Some of them are saying that it may not be important, but maybe it earns some money. And some of them are saying that no, this is the pathway to the future. There are those in that lot who have understood this. And what we are trying to do here, all of us who are sitting here, all of us are trying to make 10 more people understand that that torch can become a bonfire, that light can become a blaze, and that blaze can actually make a trail for us, can put the name of Rajasthan into lights. And that's where we, you and I, are going. You know, when I went to World Economic Forum, and I went to World Economic Forum in 2005-06 it was, I had some people with me, and we were just, because like for the first time going to World Economic Forum, it was like going to a big museum. And so we were just wandering from room to room. It happened that we fell into a room where the Queen of Jordan was actually taking a meeting with every single important computer manufacturer of the world, from Dell to Cisco, they were all there. And while we sat open-mouthed and listened, she actually dealt with them to talk to them to say that my country requires all of you to work with us to create this computer literacy amongst the people of my country. Now the people of my country, which we were talking about, was maybe smaller than Jaipur. Maybe the same as Jaipur. Now we are talking about something which is much, much larger, but we brought the education initiative back to Rajasthan for the first time. And I have to tell you, there was such excitement. The teachers were excited, the training, the guys who were training, they were excited. Everybody had this feeling that we were on the threshold of something new. That gave a huge energy to a lot of our people. Today, the people that you've seen pass on the stage, in their own way, they have contributed. And I've been around to see this contribution to various fields, whether it was medical education, whether it was going down to the villages with e-mitras, whether it was creating convergences. It is an exciting time. It's a time when the government of Rajasthan is waking up to immense, enormous possibilities that perhaps it would not have been able to see. And by the way, let me tell you, this is awakening is not on its own. There are lots of young people over here who have created that buzz and who have made us proud of them and who have made us feel that if we can produce people like Prashant Patni and those who did Kar Dekho and those who have come up with so many other startups, can we not, if there were 10 of them, can we not 200? And so with all that in mind, there's a whole new thing that's happening. And I'm very excited about it. I think you should be very excited about it. And I think together, we should be able to take that excitement down to all those who still are wondering, what is this that everyone's getting so excited about? So I'm going to tell you that the basic idea was Suraj. And I have now come to the understanding that there can be no Suraj if we don't get this IT track in place. If that is in place, then all those things that we talk about, Suraj, can all come together to create a real vibrant economy as far as Rajasthan is concerned. And as you all know, there is a downturn. As you all know, we're going through some troubled times. As you all know, we had legacy issues which we are grappling with even now. But if we had to moan and groan and stay, then we would be really far behind everybody. What we need to know is that these are the difficulties, but these are the ways that we can take to actually overcome those difficulties. And without difficulties, life is not interesting, is it? I mean, how would you like it if you were given your favorite food day in and day out? You'd get really bored. So I've come to the conclusion that if you don't have the difficulties, if you don't have hills to climb, if you don't have aspirations, if you don't want to touch the stars, if you don't want to fly to the moon, then really, you are all going to be terribly, terribly bored. So the time has come for us to reach out and do all these exciting things, and none of this is possible without IT. So today in Rajasthan, we're sharing the tools of technology and we're trying to change the lives of everyday people. So from the points of sale machines to ration shops, and by the way, that's a very interesting one. People that got used to, you know what the ration shops were like, they were just holes in the wall, open maybe 2 days in the week. But the POS machines and your biometrics have changed that. Today you have 300 shops, by June you'll have 5,000 shops that were ration shops, and hopefully in the next 3 years we should be able to try to convert at least 15 to 16 to 18,000 shops in which you just don't have ration. But alongside ration you also have a small retail, and that small retail caters for the needs of the people of that area, from shampoo to toothpaste to chips to tea, to whatever else you want, at cheaper prices, but on that POS and biometrics. And just imagine going to that ration ki dukan, but not with your little book in hand. That little book was actually very, very dangerous to a lot of lives. That little book could be kept with you, it could be kept with the person who had the ration shop. And you know what kind of things happened there, and how the grain found its way back into the market. With the POS machine, with a biometric, there is no way that any leakages will now occur. And that would not have happened without IT. So this is why it's so very important to us. Today I know that if I go into that shop and I use my biometric and I say, of my 35 kilos, I just want to take 10 kilos and I don't have space in my place, that's a small place. I'll just take 10 kilos of gehu, 1 kilo of sugar and maybe something else from the next door shop. I give my biometric and I go away with my things, and on the phone I get a message 10 minutes later to tell me, or rather immediately to tell me, that I now have 25 kilos of wheat left, so much of sugar left, so much of whatever else I could have taken left, and that I can access this at and when I wish to. So IT has changed my life. And obviously, this is not something that is only slippages, because people like Kishore Biyani, a future group, would never have partnered with Rajasthan if it didn't hold a future. And when I asked him, he said it's one of the best ideas that we've had so far. He said, not only do I want to do it in Rajasthan, but I do know that when I do it in Rajasthan, there are going to be lots of others who are going to want to compete for this, and I will be given the opportunity because lots of other states will want to come and do the same thing. I'm happy to tell you that many states have already come and looked at that program and gone away, and I'm sure that shortly, the problems that most people have to face will not be faced anymore, because this is now going to go directly to the people. Now, if you look at this, the integrated financial management system, this has made life so much more simpler for us in government. Easy and fast, work together with the departments. Everyone used to work in silos, now we work together. Our approach is now a three-pronged approach. It's an IT-centric simplification, ease in government-to-citizen interface. And that's important for us because I always found there was a gap between the two. How do you bridge that gap? You use IT. IT-centric public infrastructure improvement. IT-centric business process re-engineering, basically getting you service delivery and efficiency. And I think that is what every one of us wants. I will only showcase my state if I'm able to tell them that it's better than any other, particularly in the delivery of services. So the last mile connectivity, which is what we're looking at, and which has been given to us, Bhamasha became your first direct benefit transfer program and platform. It is one of the best programs today. It is available to cash and non-cash. And yes, at this moment in time, the Aadhaar seeding is still not available to us. We're still trying to get that. Once we get it, hopefully we do get it. If we get it, life will become much easier, because between Aadhaar, Jandhan, and Bhamasha, I believe that we'll be able to, using these three platforms, give Rajasthan a leg up, perhaps before most other states. So that's a really good beginning. Because remember, we came with direct benefit transfer at a time when no one believed in it. I remember how hard we had to try to get one bank to work with us. Today, every bank is in line. Things have changed in the last 15 years. The Raj Sampark portal you had a look at. Well, what we're looking for is now cybercrime units, which we want to set up in each of the police ranges, because this is also going to make a difference to life. And e-enablement will continue to be a priority for us in most of the departments, and in fact in every department in the time to come. So I would like to say over here that the officers have worked very, very hard to further this mission of getting this e-governance spread across the state. And I want to congratulate all of you, all of those people who have worked hard to get their prizes, because I really do believe that this is extremely good for the state, and you will stand out as examples within government, and hopefully others will follow from where you have left off, and they will also continue to spread the good word across the state. We want efficient service, we want efficient grievance redressal, but as I said to everybody, grievance redressal also, I mean, you know, there is grievance redressal and grievance redressal. We have to be sympathetic with other people within the city also. And we have to understand that grievance redressal has to be very personal. If it's going to involve 20 other people, then it becomes a grievance redressal for 20 other people. So we have to be careful the way we use it. And basically the idea is to make people happy. So small things which you can't get done otherwise, where you'd have to go backward and forward, if you use the portal, you'll probably be able to get it done quickly. And I'm looking to add, therefore, what I call the happiness index for our people into the broad spectrum of what? And the road to progress. So now, skilled manpower, extremely important for us. Startups, hugely important for us. Incubation for and facilitation, germination of new ideas. Not just one incubation center, but many across. Our dream is to actually go ahead to make Rajasthan the startup, incubation, and entrepreneurship hub of Northern India. Do you think we can do it? You don't sound very convinced. Do you think we can do it?
Yes.
Because you have to believe in yourself. This is not just government. It's all of us. Every one of us. If we believe in ourselves, then that huge collective energy goes towards actually making it happen in the state. So that's why I keep getting you to say yes to this. So IT policy of 2015, bringing in talented youth from across Rajasthan that require launch pads to keep moving. A policy that supports investment, not just in IT, but in the electronic systems development and manufacture, that ESDM sector. All of this, if you look at RIPS 2014, you will find that it finds a mention in that. Today, I'm very proud to be able to dedicate RajNet, because this network is now going to connect Gram Panchayats to Jaipur. This was a very first. I believe that this is going to get better and better as the days go by. I believe that people down in the panchayats are going to feel comfortable using this network and getting their work done. So as I said, again, we are now going to be in the process, and I would like today to announce to you all a startup council in which we all will be there, but we want to bring in energy from outside. So I should be announcing that very shortly. Please look forward to that, because I believe that apart from what we will be doing in government, what the government officers will be doing, we are open to ideas outside, and therefore not just for education, not just for health, but particularly for things like IT, we need fresh air, we need people with new ideas, and we're going to look forward to that. So therefore this council is going to be extremely, extremely useful for us. And finally, our philosophy of government and governance is actually partnerships. Government doesn't know it all. Government can't do it all unless we are partnered by you all. So I believe that the energy in future is not just going to come from government, because government becomes smaller and smaller as the days go by, but it's going to become hugely important because of the energy that is going to go into this, not just from government, but from all of you seated here today. So working together, we can actually achieve much more than we would have done working alone or working in silos. So I'm urging you all the young startups and all the entrepreneurs, to please be our partner in Rajasthan's quest for a better tomorrow. So I want to thank you all for being over here today. I love the energy that you all have. I believe it's this energy that's going to make a difference to us in time to come. So lots of love to all of you. I just hope you all make this happen. Smile, but you know, push it. Can we do it? Can we do it? That's great. Thank you all very, very much. Thank you.